thank you for joining us here today. With me is the Shadow Minister for Prime Industries and Water, Dr. Shane Broad, and Fruitgrass Tasmania President Nick Hansen. We've just met with a number of growers affected within the control zone as a result of the fruit fly incursion in recent days. We have met with the growers and producers to provide an update on the current situation. Quite clearly, this is having a significant impact on individual businesses and individual people and families. And this has been quite an emotional roller coaster over the course of the last 10 days or so since the first detection. There are no further detections. We still have four infected properties and no more infected properties, which is a good sign. As I said yesterday, we are going to destroy these little buggers. They are an absolute menace, and we are going to make sure that we maintain our market access internationally in our key sensitive markets, those protocol markets such as Taiwan and China. Today I have consulted with my opposition spokesperson and agreed on a $2 million support package for the affected growers. This is important. We need to stand shoulder to shoulder as both government and opposition in a bipartisan way and stand shoulder to shoulder together with those producers that have been affected. The reason why we're here today to announce some $2 million support package, and this may well be a down payment on further support that we can offer our affected producers within the control zone. Biosecurity Tasmania and indeed industry themselves have been working very hard together over the course of the last 10 days, but particularly the last week. That's what we're demonstrating through our strengthened system approach, if I can put it that way, and working very closely together. Now, we've met with a number of producers already that have been spoken to and briefed throughout the hours of this morning and indeed collectively here today.
So what we have here is a nightmare scenario for growers with a nightmare pest in just a place where you wouldn't want to see it. Just within the control zone, we have both distribution centres, logistics centres and growers. So that makes this very complicated, and what we saw today was that everybody in that room was impacted in a different way, which it makes it very complicated. But one thing I will say is that because of this nightmare scenario, we will stand up for Tasmanian vegetable and fruit growers to make sure that fruit fly is eradicated, because it is a nightmare pest. We do not want it here. It is not welcome. We need to eradicate it. We need to keep our markets open. So what we see here in this nightmare scenario is that there are people who are impacted. They're going to be going home right now and throwing out all their products. So they've put their heart and soul into these products. The products are on the shelves. Some of them are actually in the trucks going to the market. And now they have to turn around and cancel those orders and throw out everything they've got left. So that's heartbreaking for these growers. That's why this is a nightmare scenario. That's why they need support. And that's why we'll stand together with the government and back in this support.
Growers are certainly affected. It's certainly the increasing of the protocol requirements within the control area has certainly come as a shock to some of them. They're working through the situation as we speak. A lot of growers have remained inside. They're talking to one another and talking to the major retail supermarkets that are in there as well. But I would like to say that growers, fruit growers, vegetable growers, we're used to adversity. We are, by very nature, adverse people in these sort of circumstances. Adversity comes as hail, it comes as rain, it can come as disease pressure, it can come as many faces. This is a face that we haven't seen before, the fruit fly. And we'll get through it. All the growers know that. Fruit Growers Tasmania stands behind them. The Minister of the day, Mr. Jeremy Rockliffe, stands behind us, as does the opposition. And as growers, we fully respect that. Plus, we also have the resources of biosecurity and the Department of Primary Industries, and that is fantastic news for all our growers. Adversity, sometimes as growers, we don't get a support package if we get hail or if we get rain on our cherries. So in this instance, we have a support package behind us. The $2 million potentially is a down payment only, But as we've said, the growers are very resilient and they will try at every turn to find alternative markets for their produce. Well, some businesses with the extra regulations in place would supply 80% of their produce into Tasmanian markets. That, at present, until fumigation becomes an option for that business, is not available to them. Other businesses would be supplying 100% of their produce into Tasmanian markets. Again, when fumigation and cold sterilisation becomes an option, they will be able to re-enter the Tasmanian market.